Good evening, everyone. So we actually came across, we bought a new microscope, which was M822. And we were looking for a recording system for that, predominantly for an anterior segment work. I haven't used this system for retinal surgeries as such. So we came across this person who was selling microscopes to dental industry. So dentistry also uses a lot of microscopes. And they had this modified system, which is basically a CCTV system, which they incorporate into these microscopes. And we tried it out, and this is what we have. So this is the system that we have. So it is a 822 microscope with a 70-30 beam splitter. So this is good for anterior segment because most of it is done under topical anesthesia. So you can keep the light less harsher, and the surgeon can visualize it almost as clearly. We have a manual F55mm video adapter. That's the video adapter. And this is the HD surveillance camera. So the camera as such is a 5-megapixel Sony sensor. It's a single chip camera. It has ultra low light sensitivity. So even at the smallest of light, it can pick up. It has multiple recording modes. So I can put a USB cable connected to the computer, and via a software interface can record the videos. Or there is a SD card slot which can take up to 32 GB card, and I can directly record it onto the SD card. And if I directly record it through the SD card, then I get a 60 frame per second video. And if I record it through the USB, then it's a 30 frame per second video. The good part is that it has an OSD, on-screen display, so I'll show you what it is. And approximately 10 minutes of video can record about, will take about 200 MB. So almost the entire day's surgery can fit into one or two 32 GB SD cards. And this has an electronic rolling shutter. So Dr. Raju was speaking about shutters. Most of these current generation cameras have digital shutters in them. So this has a rolling shutter, but I'm told that the newer generation of this camera comes with a global shutter. So these global shutters are good where the movement is very quick. So like an anterior segment surgery where things are happening a little faster, like FACO or something like that. So these shutters work well in these instances. And this is the layout on the top of the camera. So that's the USB. The USB doubles also that you can put in a wireless mouse over there. So the dongle of the mouse goes there. And the HDMI gets connected to a HDTV in the OT. That's the power input, so it doesn't have a battery. So there's no need to recharge and all those things, so directly it runs on raw power. That's the SD card slot there, and that's the camera on and off button. So there were two systems. Now, I mentioned about the OSD. OSD is on-screen display. So this doesn't need a computer again. The camera itself has a program through which when we move the cursor to the extreme left of the TV, then all these menus pop up over there. So while the surgeon is operating, the staff can adjust the gain, the gamma, the contrast. He can change from auto white balance to locking the white balance. And if you go to the other side, then you have a couple of other things, like there's a measurement tool, there is a horizontal, vertical, there's a digital zoom. So if there's any particular region that the attendant, the OT assistant needs to zoom, then pressing on button will zoom the image in that zone. Then it has a grid and other things. Post-surgery, again, you do not, if you want to review the video in between surgeries, then there is a way that you can do it. You can go back to the review tool, and it shows up all the day's videos in this grid. So this is all incorporated into the camera. You don't need a computer to see all these things in the OT. So it becomes very simple and good for places where there is space constraint. So this is all the advantages with the system that we have. And these are some disadvantages. Again, they are subjective. So it's a single CMOS chip. As of now, it is compatible against Labomed, Zeiss, and the Leica microscopes. And it is not available in 4K. I still do not have an experience in using it for VR surgeries because it's put in the anterior segment OT. So I'll show you the recordings that we have made on that. Video folder. So to show you how the white balance adjusts, then automatically as soon as the light, the retro reflex is switched on, the white balance matches so that the region of interest becomes more clearer. So the images are pretty crisp. So you can see the visco moving to fill the anterior chamber. Let me get to the rexus directly. So I think it's much clearly represented in the television. I think there's a red saturation in the display. So you can very crisply see the capsular margin over there, the anterior capsular margin, the capsulotomy margin. So the hydrodissection wave. Yeah. So this is some of the record. And as Dr. Raju sir was saying,